Hi, welcome back to Sara Daily, where we give you our best simple, actionable, reliable advice to help you grow and scale your small business. Today, we are talking about how to stoke your creativity when you're feeling down. This is really important because we have all had these days. I know I'm not alone here, where you sit down to do something creative, to write or to think about the future or some decisions you want to make in your business, and you just can't access that creative feeling. This is very common for business owners, especially in times of stress or hardship, which a lot of us have experienced in the last year. So here's a few things that I recommend through my experience and working with so many small business owners to help you stoke creativity. The first thing is to move your body. And this doesn't mean that you have to take up a sport or have a lot of hard physical exertion. It may mean that you just need to get up from your desk and go for a walk. It may mean that you need to go spend a little bit of time outside. Go sit at a coffee shop with your notebook instead of at the computer. Try moving your body. Try getting some sunlight. Try stirring up the creative juices by letting your body just kind of flow instead of sitting down in a rigid, structured position with the idea that you're just going to pour out a bunch of creativity. The second thing is to try mental wondering or daydreaming. This is something that we all probably naturally do, but if you don't let yourself, if you don't set aside or give yourself permission, it might feel like a luxury or a waste of time. But it is a really powerful way to get your creativity going again, to literally set aside time to just think and let your mind wander. There's lots of ways to do this. Music can trigger this, a comfortable part of your home, maybe going for a drive, something where you're able to just let your mind wander because you don't have anything else distracting you. And use things like music or locations or smells, those type of things to trigger the brain and see what comes up in your mental wandering. And then the third thing is, a lot of people recommend this, is to use your hands. So even if you have to do something in your business that's like copywriting or bookkeeping or something that requires like some creative focus where you're having to problem solve come up with words, using your hands in a creative way that's not related to your business is a really good way to get the two parts of the brain connected again. So whether you're a painter or you'd love to garden or you want to cook something, starting to use your hands and letting your mind focus on the tactile sensation of what you're doing with your hands is a really good way to get the brain back into creative mode. Not necessarily that you would be there baking something and also doing your copywriting, but if you hit one of those mental blocks where you just can't get the creative stuff to come out, taking a minute to go do something with your hands is a great way to help the brain come back into that creative space. So the next time you're feeling blocked with your creativity, try one of these tips, move your body, do some mental wondering, some daydreaming, use your hands, see if those things are good tools for you to get you back into creative mode. Thanks for watching. For more tips like this, check out the community, our online membership mastermind for small business owners to help you grow and scale. We would love to see you in there. See you soon.